You know,
I also write. I write songs with Miss Roberta Flack and Quincy Jones and so forth.
Maya Angelou held multi-generational appeal. So in the last few minutes of our interview, she shared some sage advice for young people to help them prepare for the life journey ahead.
I would ask them, please read. I know they live in a new world, the world of technology. I know that they have the iPads and all these other things, laptops and stuff. But I would love them to spend at least a few hours every week reading. It's amazing how you belong, the words belong to you, and you learn somehow to write them. Open a book of poetry, see if you can't find something that says something to your heart, to your spirit. And as soon as you do, write a few words.
To meditate on the wisdom that Dr. Maya Angelou offered and to be inspired by her life and her works, visit this show page on worldfootprints.com for a direct link to her family's legacy website.
In this destination spotlight, Murat Karakoç from Turkish Tourism shines a light on Turkey from the New York Times Travel Show.
Turkey is a huge, one of the biggest touristic destination in the world. It is considered one of the biggest open-air destination in the world. It is formed a bridge between East and West. Not only geopolitically, geographically, but also historically. Turkey itself represents the background of the Romans, Byzantines, and the Ottomans throughout the history. More than 36 ancient civilizations lived the current Turkish territories. So in every single part of the country, you can see different civilizations, ruins and remnants. So that's why we call the country one of the biggest open-air museums. Let's say in Cappadocia. Cappadocia is one of our major destinations, especially for the North Americans. Each year, approximate 300,000 Americans visit Cappadocia. The area, it's a volcanic area now, old volcanic area. Now it's a rough stones and rocks shaped by climate, like winds, like erosion, which gives people different opportunities. The area is also important for the early Christianity.
How so is
around 3rd century to 6th century, in early Christianity, when the Roman empires pressing the Christians, early Christians, the people hiding themselves in the underground cities of the Cappadocia. That's a huge city, like a hotel. And cities linked, connected to each other via underground tunnels. There are some 60 kilometers, let's say more than 40 miles tunnels. Just imagine. During these 300 years, people just try to keep their beliefs in that area, because the area was easy to construct underground city because of the feature of those stones. So the area is very important for the religious tourism.
Michele Wood is an artist whose work reflects a deep sense of history and place. As a painter, illustrator, designer, and writer, she has gained wide recognition and has earned multiple awards, including the prestigious American Book Award for her first book, Going Back Home. She's also won a Coretta Scott King Illustrator Award from the American Library Association for her book, I See the Rhythm. And Michele's artistry explodes in I See the Rhythm of Gospel. And I understand this is really the first time the art form of gospel music has been blended with Black history in a book. What led you and your partner in rhythm, I'm calling her, Toyomi Igas, to create this work?
This is kind of a different journey. How we got started, or how I got started, is that an idea had came to me. It was backwards. Our format is backwards, where the writing, the artists come first, and then the writing comes afterwards. And in this book, it was the idea of I wanted to do gospel, and I felt it in my spirit to do it. And I sat on the idea for about a year until I approached Toy.
The book covers some monumental moments in Black history, stretching way back to the beginning of slavery in the 1500s. How were you able to condense this history into an illustrative picture book?
There's so much history. It's very hard to narrow that down, because we have to weigh out who had the most influence at that time period, who stood out more than others. And because there's so many musicians, as you look at the time period that came about and that had influence, and some lasted more decades than others, they're more influenced, like the women of gospel music. Mm-hmm. You have Shirley Caesar of her time period, and one person that I fought for was Rosetta Thorpe. Because when I saw her and read her life story, and then saw some, you can go on YouTube and see videos of her and listen to her guitar and the people that she influenced, she was very radical, reminding me of how they used to say about Bo Diddley when he went to Chess Records after he went to VJ Records, and they said he was too radical, and then he goes to Chess Records and he blows up. But when you have Rosetta Tharpe and you listen to her guitar playing, where she had that blues influence, but she brought that gospel sound, mm-hmm. and she was just a pioneer of her time. And she was before her time to me. So we looked for pioneers and people who were out front. And that's how we narrowed it down. It was very difficult for us. But the things that I put in my paintings, I tried to translate. I have to look at clothes. I have to look at the time period. I have to look at, like in the 50s, it's more pastels, or it's how the buildings were. And I didn't want to focus on just the musicians. I wanted to focus on the people.
This book really is transcendent of just the experience of African Americans from a religious standpoint. It covers the totality of history, and it connects it to so many things that have happened around the world. How did Yes. you arrive at the approach for tying in early history from the 15th century to the arrival of Barack Obama in 2008?
You start from the beginning, and starting from Africa and the influence of Africa on American, American music, and how the call and response that you have in the music and the drums and everything is all connected to one. You even have where we even get to jazz, where there's a little bit of influence, was that rhythm sound, was the blues sound, but it got into gospel. You just have to go through all the research and try to incorporate as much as possible and connect the dots as much as possible as you can. But we're all connected. Even from this rhythm, holy hip-hop, you find those rhythms, those same rhythms are still in the music. And it's like the core of the music, the core of the beat. And it's like the timekeeper, the drummer is the timekeeper. So it's all linked together.
You're listening to World Footprints Radio with Ian and Tanya Fitzpatrick. We are speaking to award-winning artist Michele Wood about America's history as explored through the gospel, which she illustrates in her book, I See the Rhythm of Gospel. Visit this show page on our website at worldfootprints.com for links to Michele's works. How does one go about capturing history and distilling it to a single image? How was that challenge for you?
I don't see my work as just a single image because it's a continuation from one image to another, like the image that is about slavery and about Harriet Tubman. And in that, you do have a little girl that's in the back of it. Her name is Missy, and she's going through the journeys with you, and she's going through each page as you go through it. And in that painting, there's different symbols that's layering and that's telling the history and indicating, like, the leaf that's on her dress, that they're going north, and where they're going is to Canada. But during that time period, and researching the flags and of that time period, it wasn't a leaf. But we wanted to communicate that more literally than to confuse you. And then, and like the Underground Railroad, having the railroad in the water. Well, Missy's all is based on me, and my nickname when I was a little girl name is Missy, and the only people that will call me Missy are family members. So till this day, if I go out and someone says Missy, I know that it's a family member. And my mother called me Missy, and she would tell me and always encourage me, there's more to see than Indiana. There's more outside your boundaries. So my mother didn't work in she didn't have a lot of money, but when she did, she would take me to New York, or she'll take me to the Bahamas or Kings Island, or wherever she could take me, Chicago, to the Science Museum. She would just take me and show me there's more to see. So, and putting it in I See the Rhythm, I also, you know, start noticing that it was in my other paintings. Like in Going Back Home, Missy's there sitting on her aunt's knee, mm-hmm. and she's getting her hair braided. Missy just came about more subconsciously, and then now she's just a fabric. She's there all the time.
Michele, one of the things that is remarkable from my standpoint about the book is that it really takes one all over the world, from Bronzeville on Chicago's south side to Harlem to South Africa. It touches on a lot of places that speak to me.
In Black history, and as well as, you know, and I say very much that it's America's history, because I don't pinpoint it to just to say it's Black history. America is such a melting pot. And it's our history. And I want also children to be proud, African-American children, to be proud of their history and their contribution to society. It's so much that we've done. Mm-hmm. And it's so much that we've captured in this book, and so much to be proud of. And I look at the faith, you know, we had to have had so much faith, and that's so much that you can embody, is to have, you know, faith and to believe in a future, to believe that there's something better, and to keep pushing. And keep pushing and push through slavery and depression and the civil rights movement, and just keep going until we're here today, and we're still pushing forward. And it's amazing how much strength that we have as people, mm-hmm. you know, and that we're growing, and we have a Black president now. But look at the person that prayed before, the person that had the faith and to get through those troubled times to get to where we are today. And I am so thankful for those that have gone before us and for those that are paving the way today.
To appreciate some of Michele Wood's illustrations and other works, visit the show page on worldfootprints.com for a direct link to her website.